His resume spans across 6 countries, tallying 12 cathedrals, 1 basilica, and a half dozen restorations to churches hundreds of years old. A simple internet search of his name will show offers to buy home decor he created, priced anywhere between $1,000 to nearly $100,000. So how is it that stained glass artist Max Ingrand got commissioned for a church that, unlike the many monolithic cathedrals he worked on, remains unseen from the countless bypassers on one of Chicago's busiest streets, Toohey Avenue?
The term Chicagoland area does not just refer to the city of Chicago, it also covers over 70 different suburbs. In the 1950s and 60s, there was sudden growth of Chicago churches and schools throughout the entire Chicagoland area.
The decades of the Great Depression and World War II paused the inception of new parishes in the Chicago diocese until the baby boom era.
You can see that during World War II and after World War II, things picked up again. You know, especially out toward the 50s and 60s, most of the parishes were out in the suburbs. And St. Mary of the Woods shows up right here in this time period where things were expanding out into the suburbs.
The humble and small St. Mary of the Woods, located right here across the street at the northernmost point of the city's boundaries, was one of those parishes.
It's a beautiful summer day here in Chicago, but Chicago is also notorious for having very harsh winters. But number 6 on the list of bad winters in Chicago was the winter of 1951-52. And in that year, when school reopened for the second semester of classes after winter break, students in the Wildwood section of Edgebrook couldn't get to class over here. The buses couldn't get through. So it was decided what was needed was a new parish in the Chicago Archdiocese. And that is how St. Mary of the Woods was founded.
Originally established in 1952 on account of local parents petitioning for a new Catholic school, it was only one decade later that St. Mary of the Woods had completely doubled in size. The few building augmentations that had taken place only temporarily helped with the growing number of school students. By the early 1960s, it was evident that the parish needed something grander.
A decision was made in the early 1960s for St. Mary of the Woods to undertake a major project that would significantly increase the size of the church. The architect and parishioner of the original church and school facade, John Vosen, had conceptualized an expansion that would utilize floor-to-ceiling stained glass windows. Well aware of the respected glass artists in Paris, France, Vosen commissioned Max Ingrand to create a landscape that would essentially be a woods of stained glass. Ingrand's career began in the late 1920s as a glass etcher, also known as French embossing, a technique that creates a translucent effect on the surface of glass through a sandblasting process.
Sandblasting is the technique of shooting sand at a piece of glass. You will mask over the parts that you do not want affected with a piece of tape, and then the sand will remove all of the parts that are not taped to create a pattern inside the pane of glass.
Ingrand's early work earned him a couple of private commissions for stained glass projects in the 1930s. Yet in the fall of 1939, with World War II officially underway, Ingrand was drafted into the French military, yet was captured the following year, 1940, in the German town of Heudestra. For over 4 years, Ingrand remained a POW in Nazi-occupied Poland all the way through to the end of the war.
Following the fall of Nazi Germany, in the spring of 1945, Ingrand was released and went back to France, and some of the first jobs he was hired for was stained glass repairs.
Stained glass is the traditional art form of taking panes of glass, and you would put copper around the outside, and then you will melt the edges of the pane of glass together. And then you would make a large structure out of using small colored glass to create a uniform art piece, a mural. There are different techniques where you can do some engraving on the glass plane, so a image could be appeared out of a blue background. You might have a white figure or whatnot.
In the subsequent years, Ingrand became one of the most sought-after stained glass artists, so much so that by the mid-1960s, When Vosen was pursuing Ingrand for the job in Chicago, Illinois, Ingrand had amassed significant acclaim, including Saint-Pierre de Yvette, which was, and remains, the largest stained glass window in Europe. Ingrand's qualifications far exceeded that of a neighborhood church, especially one of many that were springing up in the Chicago suburbs during that era. Yet the generous donations of St. Mary's First Families secured Ingrand for the job, giving their small local parish a piece of artwork from one of the premier experts of stained glass windows. Ingrand's initial sketches were enlarged and then foam pieces were cut into place until the exact color match of glass could be found. The glass was cut and cemented into place in Europe before the full glass panels were shipped to the United States for installation.
What Max Ingrand created for St. Mary of the Woods were these floor-to-ceiling stained glass walls of forest with multicolored trees, leaves, vines, and birds. Yet scattered throughout these woods are eight depictions of the Blessed Mother. Each version of Mary represents a different spiritual devotion to the Blessed Mother practiced by Catholics for many centuries. Two paintings, five apparitions, and a spiritual devotion make up what this physical church intends to teach us. In the medieval period, the artwork in churches was intended to teach and explain the faith to the people. In keeping with that tradition, we've brought together a variety of experts with insight about these eight Marian stained glass windows.